Are you talking of South Africa? Ordinary, special concepts remain the same, except that this number will change to 65. That's why MTN deal, Bharti was aiming for 65%. Logic to here. My current assignment is, I love training, right? In fact, I miss my full-time academics days. But my current assignment is acquiring a Brazilian-based company. First thing that we have done, even before we started that valuation, is we went across and said, what is that law? See, yes, we'll have to talk to some legal guy there and check out, in your jurisdiction, to pass a special resolution, to pass an ordinary resolution, can you give me the figures? And then we start working, what is known as control print. Please note one last example, again out of sheer respect, but to just make it practical. Harish sir, we all know one thing. I'm not sure a colleague from Deloitte will know this, but we all know this, at least in caps, that Arcom was about to acquire the assets of Hutch. Everything was done. Arcom was about to acquire the assets of Hutch. Due diligence was done, ma'am. Everything was done. Valuation was fixed. They didn't factor in something. What they didn't factor in, Mr. Krishna, Aduji, Sashish, Arun, what they didn't factor in is RUIAs. The SRs, RUIAs came in and said, you want to sell, you sell. You want to buy, you buy. We will oppose the special resolution. We are not saying anything. You buy. We will oppose the special resolution. Hello? SRs still has 33% stake. Now, if they are going to oppose, and you will wonder why they are opposing, nothing. It's simple payback time. Okay, why they were opposing it? Simple payback, right? All of us know that, and if you are in industry, you know, SR Oil, the entire troubles was thanks to Reliance, okay, and, right, Ambani is ensuring that, right, there are screw-ups for SRs. SRs realize now is payback time. Anybody else except Reliance? We have no problem. And by the way, we are not saying you don't sell. You sell. We'll vote against you. Excuse me, 33% stake, sir. Please understand that is the call of having a special resolution in place. That's 75. Please note, if that would have been 23% stake, I should have said, come on, we are going ahead. That 33% is up for sale. And you came across as a very good audience. I do not tell you, even this fallen valuations for Indian telecom, Vodafone is ready to pay $5 billion. Even with this valuation, say telecom valuations, better not spoken in public audience. It is raised to the bottom, right? The only thing is now they have to pay consumers for using the phone, right? The remaining they have done, 1 paise per minute, right? Please understand, right? The entire model is $5 billion, sir. Please understand, what is the logic? They got it right. I salute them. They got that. They even now, if you see the controversy, SR is trying to get more than $5 billion, which according to me is, right? I salute them, at least that's an Indian mind, you know. If you get somebody, extract the maximum out from that guy, right? Please understand, right, Neoga. Vodafone also is smart, right? You just watch that, that will get close at 5. Even that 5 billion is too big an amount, yeah. Fact is, 75%, right, moment you cross, you are the deemed owner of the company. Unfortunately, in Vodafone, they don't have that entire assets. Having said this, took you through equity, please combine this learning with your PEVC. Can I spend 1 minute and then take all your questions, which will be a pleasure. For those of you all who are planning to have PEVCs, try and give them less than 25%. No, I'm concerned. That's the way I am. And I know I'm not your consultant. It's my social duty. Try and give less than 25%. If you give more than 25%, please extract as high as control premium as possible. No PEVC is doing you a favor by investing in your company. Today, there is enough in the market. If you are good, you will get the money. If you are not good, then I will not like to venture. But I believe I am looking at companies which have got stable cash flows. Any questions on equity? It would be a pleasure to take up, please. Yeah, please.
You gave an example of 25% and 75%. 50%
I'm sorry.
Promoter, right?
No, no, no. I'm sorry, I went fast there. Then you have the right to pass ordinary resolutions. So my day-to-day running, I'll again go back to a dear friend. I have more than 50% in Pranav Saab's company. I don't need his permission for day-to-day running. But if I have to do a merger, I want to do a project finance, I'll have to have him with me. Please, please, sir. Satyam was a case of absolute capex, sir. Right? And Satyam was a case where he could have passed the case. But Satyam's case was not actually that. You are talking of the reverse merger, na, sir?
No,
yeah. Sir, it was, though he was showing it as Maitas and Satyam, actually what that, I'm sorry, I have to use this term, what the poor guy or Raju was trying to do is cover that big hole in his balance sheet. Baad mein ye logo samjha. He put it as that I'm going into real estate. Actually, he had no assets, and you know, right? Her company was zilched, right? I'll just spend 2 minutes on Satyam. So Satyam case kya tha, sir? He used that Satyam's money to buy real estate. Then what he taught is, and personal money also was involved. Then what he taught is, he will drive the Hyderabad metro along that route where he has purchased real estate. So the moment the Hyderabad metro comes in, real estate prices will go up. He will sell and make his money. Unfortunately, the subprime crisis happened. Unfortunately for him, right? The subprime crisis happened. Prices fell. He got into a trap. Or a paisa funding kaise liya tha, sir? He had pledged his own shares with India Bulls to raise that money. Share prices fell. India Bulls started making margin calls or shares now. He gave more shares. Again, prices fell, unfortunately. Again, margin call. Finally, he had no shares. And that's where he realized my game is up. Satyam case, if you want to read, again, just sharing with you, I've read a couple of books. The best one I've read is Satyajit's one on Satyam Saga. The book's name itself is Satyam Saga. So if you're wondering, right, what has happened, my source is this book. And by the way, since we have some colleagues who are from the infra field, can I introduce one more term through Satyam? Thank you for that, sir. Thank you. Right? There's something known as, in infra financing, which is known as VGF. Viability gap funding. Viability gap funding. Thank you for that, Satyam. Also, I can give you one more term. It is not an infra class per se, but I want to give you one more term. VGF stands for viability gap funding. What it technically means, sir, ma'am, is what it technically means is if you want any project to be viable and you don't think it is viable, you can go to the government and the government in turn, you can go to a government and government in turn will fund you either by way of lump sum payment or government will give you yearly annuities so that your project is viable. That is why this term is viability gap funding. I'll spend 1 minute more on Satyam. So the Satyam case, actually if you look back, there was a gentleman who found out that there was something wrong in Satyam. And that was not Merrill Lynch. It was not PwC. It was a gentleman by the name of Mr. Sridharan, who was in charge of Hyderabad Metro. Suddenly, one fine day, he came in and said, I'm resigning. This is real estate play. This is not a metro project. This is a real estate play. Why? Because if you read the book, it comes out clearly. When Maitas bid for the Hyderabad Metro, there were two or three other bidders. One, I believe, was the Reliance Consortium, which is always there. L&T Consortium was number two. Reliance, I believe, was number three. L&T was number two. When the other consortium members were asking for money from the government to invest, Maitas was the only bidder who did negative VGF. They went across and told the government, we will pay you for this project. And Sridharan said, you will pay. On what basis? Where is this metro viable? And he caught up and said, this is not a metro project, this is a real estate project. He gave a signal right about, yeah, that's finance. That, I read that article myself, but I could never place it with Satyam till, after, again I repeat, after the event happened. Please understand, right, 9 months earlier he said, Satyam said, we'll file a defamation against you and all that. No defamation suit was filed. That clearly shows what was happening there. So please don't, right, your specific question. So it was special resolution, absolutely special resolution. Please. Yeah. This is a very generic way of my explaining this. Specifically, anything, now that you want a specific discussion, anything that will change your capital structure, right, will go as a special resolution. So if it is simple modernizing equipment or anything, right? The fact of the matter is,
it happened in London when there was a Christmas break, so all the bankers were on leave. They had got their bonuses, they won 50, they figured they could, you know.
But they won the majority of the...
No, that deal didn't go through. And then Satyam happened, so they really didn't go through
it. Sir, please note, especially for a listed company, even if the other guy, sorry, but I have to say this, some of you are listed, if the other guy does not have majority stake, he can still run havoc with your company. Simple, na, sir. He will simply come to the market and sell. You may have, sorry, but I need to tell you, you will have 76%, you will pass a special resolution. I have only 20%. But suppose I come to the market and start dumping the shares. Automatically, your share price starts moving down. It indirectly affects who the most, the promoter who has 76%. And nowadays, this activism has started, and especially with D-Shaw is a client, so I should not talk much, especially with hedge funds. Watch out for hedge funds. Hedge funds, when they move in, and they come in as an FII, they are very clear whom to take what. And incidentally, this Wokhar has not been filed by Indian domestic.